Greeting and welcome to St. Giles Presbyterian Church. We are a community of faith in the heart of the glebe, and we welcome you, whether you're members of the congregation or you're a visitor with us the first time. May God bless you and keep you. And tonight we have a wonderful program, a Taize prayer service. And this is really more of a meditative service with hymns, short phrases, and also scripture reading and prayer. And there will be also opportunity during the prayer portion that you'll be invited to pray out loud or in silence. Just a reminder that mask recommendation is still in place, and it's highly encouraged that you keep the mask on during the service. Except for myself and also our soloist when she sings and leads us in certain parts in the service. Most of the hymns that you will encounter are from the Taize community in France. And Taize community started in the 1940s as a response to what was happening in Europe during the war. And really, it was a group of young monks that wanted to gather and just pray for peace, peace and reconciliation. And that tradition stuck around and grew and now has become quite an ecumenical movement, still keeping that central focus of peace and reconciliation. And the hymns that we'll be singing, they're in the bulletin that you'll see that some are in English and some are in Latin. Sing whichever language that you feel comfortable. But if you want to follow along with the choir, generally, if it's two languages, we'll sing six times in total. And if there are two languages, we'll sing three in one language and three in another. If there are three languages, we'll sing two, two, and two. So that's the general order. Complicating this is that we do have solo. So when solos sing, and we will just hum in the background. So that's kind of what it is. And I'll give a little reminder and here and there throughout the service. And our first hymn is Come Rejoice in God, hymn 417. you may be seated and remain seated throughout the service. Otherwise, if we rise every time we sing, we'll be standing most of the time. Our next hymn is 112, Prepare the Way of the Lord. Our first reading is taken from Psalm 118, verse 20 to 26. This is the gate of the Lord. The righteous shall enter through it. I thank you that you have answered me and have become my salvation. The stone that the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Save us. We beseech you, O Lord. O Lord, we beseech you. Give us success. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Let us sing, Blessed. Bless the Lord, my soul.
Compassion and love. to anger and rich in mercy. God does not treat us according to our sins, nor repay us according to our faults. Bless the Lord, my soul.
I forgot to introduce our soloist, Bronwyn Kelly, and also our organist, Heather Rice, and my name is Paul Wu. I'm a minister of this congregation. Our second reading is taken from Psalm chapter 31, verse 9 to 16. Be gracious to me, O Lord, for I am in distress. My eye wastes away from grief, my soul and body also, for my life is spent with sorrow, and my years with sighing, and my strength fails because of my misery, and my bones waste away. I am the scorn of all my adversaries, a horror to my neighbors, an object of dread to my acquaintances. Those who see me in the street flee from me. I have passed out of mind like one who is dead, and I have become like a broken vessel. For I hear the whispering of many, terror all around, as they scheme together against me, as they plot to take my life. But I trust in you, O Lord. I say, you are my God. My times are in your hand. Deliver me from the hand of my enemies and persecutors. Let your face shine upon your servant. Save me in your steadfast love. Let us now sing hymn 446, O Lord, hear my prayer.
Thank you.
The third reading is from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 22, verse 14 to 18. When the hour came, he took his place at the table, and the apostles with him. He said to them, "I have eagerly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer, for I tell you, I will not eat it until it is fulfilled in the kingdom of God." Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he said, "Take this and divide it among yourselves, for I tell you that from now on I will not drink of the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God comes." Let us now sing hymn 206, "Jesus, Remember Me."
Thank you.
Let us now sing Wait for the Lord. And we'll sing it twice, and you will hear solo. Bronwyn will sing the solo. There are five verses of solo. And so every verse, at the end of every verse, will sing Wait for the Lord again. So sort of back and forth until the end, and then we'll sing Wait for the Lord twice, two more times.
Straight path for God. Wait.
In these prayers of the people, they will be a portion where you will be invited to join in the prayer, say a few words, a phrase, a sentence, whatever the Spirit enable and inspire you to say, or you can just pray it in the silence of your heart. Let us pray. O holy, righteous, mighty, and merciful God, we open our eyes and strain to see you. We raise our voices in prayer and hope that you will hear our call and heal us. We know that you are ever with us, yet far too often we seem to be alone. Our vision is dulled by our stubborn insistence that you come to us as we expect, that you speak to us the words that we put on our lips. Help us now to seek only you, and not the image of you which we have made, to welcome your many surprises and listen to the language that you speak. Hear our prayers in this moment, whether spoken out loud or in the silence of our hearts. Keep us, O God, from all pettiness. Let us be large in thought, in word, in deed. Hear our prayers in this moment, whether spoken out loud or in the silence of our hearts. Lord, you provide every good gift and bless us with the overflowing abundance of the earth. You invite us to enjoy these gifts, but also to be good stewards of them. Help us today to be generous and compassionate to all who need help. Hear our prayers in this moment, whether spoken out loud or in the silence of our hearts. gracious God, thank you for the gift of today. Refresh us, invite us to discover your presence in each person that we meet and in every event encountered. Shake the scale of blindness from our eyes, and that we may see you and your healing power and recognize the touch of your hand whenever you are pleased to enter our lives. Thus may we know and believe that you, our God, are in our midst today and every day, forever and ever. Amen. And our prayer concludes with the prayer that the Lord has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let us sing hymn 501, Live in Charity, Ubi Caritas. Please stand and receive this blessing. O Lord God, as you sent forth your Spirit, so too you sent us forth as agents of your kingdom. Clarify your call to us. Give us courage to do whatever is asked. May we come to realize the dignity of our unique vocation and rejoice in its entrustment. Show us the heart of Jesus as we follow the way of Christ. Send us forth with joy and trust. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with us all now and forevermore. Amen. Let us sing our remaining hymns, 424, Sing Praise and Bless the Lord, and followed by 812, Glory to God. You may be seated.